How's it going, buddy? My name is Mr. Martash, and we are going to be talking about Fallout 4. The review is now here. So let's start off with the simple question. Is this game good or is it bad? Well, in simple terms, it's good. In fact, it's great. Actually, it's amazing. This game is so good. It's so much fun. The story is so compelling after you get into it after a couple of hours. But then afterwards, you've got like 60 hours plus of game time in this game. And that's for one character. It may be more. So Fallout 4 is set in Boston after basically the nuclear bombs fall upon Boston, and now we have the Commonwealth. And basically it's a shithole. Everything's mutated, everything's horrible, and voila, we have Fallout. So when you begin the game, you start off before the bombs fall, and you create your character. You can choose a female or a male, and you can customize them to your heart's desire. You can make him try and make him look like you, or you can try to make him look like John Cena, because that is actually possible. Damn! Once you create your character, you go around, you see your wife if you picked a male character, and you have your son called Sean, and everything seems to be going off just absolutely dandy. And then the sirens go off and you have to get rushed to the bomb shelter / the vault. So you rush into the vault, and then the next time you come out of the vault, it's 200 years into the future. Why the long gap? Well, and how can you survive that long? Well, you have to play the game, because I don't really want to spoil it for you, because it's kind of a very, like, holy shit kind of moment. So the story for Fallout 4 is almost like Fallout 3 story, where you go try and find your father. Instead, now in Fallout 4 story, you try to find your son. Which is kind of boring at the start. So you're like, I've already done this trying to find someone before. But then after maybe an hour or 2 hours into the story, and then it starts introducing all these new aspects which we haven't seen before, and you just invest even more time into the story, and the story becomes even better. So let's talk about the gameplay. So the gameplay in Fallout 4 feels like a modern shooter, whereas other Fallout games always felt clunky, never felt smooth. It was always a very chore to actually shoot your damn weapon, unless you use the overpowered thing called VATS. So VATS is still in Fallout 4, but they made it less overpowered. So if you don't know what VATS is, VATS is a system where in Fallout 3 you can click the button and it'll freeze time, and then you can aim for different parts of body limbs on your enemies, choose which one has maybe possibly the highest percentage of hits, and then your character would basically shoot at that base, that one body part, so extra damage. In Fallout 4, it's still there, except it doesn't freeze time completely. It slows down time, leaving you still open to getting smacked in the face or shot by a Batman. It still has that sense of urgency, but it still has the awesomeness of VATS. So the entire game is voice acted, which is great to hear, and the voice acting in this game is amazing. The main character voice acting is great for female and male, and you may think that maybe having a voice for your character would maybe take you out of the experience a bit, since it's not your voice. But the thing is, actually for me, it actually increased the experience for me. It's made me connect to all the characters a lot more, and made me think and feel how everyone else did. So this game is so good at doing a couple of things. One is exploring. You'll be doing so much exploring in this game, and when you're not even wanting to explore. Such as, the Bethesda always tries to say the quest storyline is the easiest, and if you go along the same path as everyone else does in the story, right at the beginning of the game, then you're less likely to get smacked in the face and die by some level 20 thing. But you start walking off down a path, but then all of a sudden you see something to your right, you see something to your left, you see something down a hallway, and you immediately have to go over there to see what it is, what can you find, what's the loot going to be like, and you're going to be doing this every single step away, step in Fallout 4. Fallout 4 is a very free game. It doesn't make you feel like you can't go this way or can't go that way. It's just that if you do go that way, it's a higher chance you may die. But the thing is, you'll get more ammo, more loot, and more everything which you kind of need in Fallout 4 at the beginning of the game. So the companions in this game are awesome. Every companion's different. In fact, I haven't found all of them yet, and I want to find all of them because they're so cool. So you can only have one companion with you at the time, which is kind of a bummer. I really want to have at least two companions with me at one time. I feel like I have a squad of three rather than two. So companions, they drive along the story, and they also have some quests for them as well, which is really awesome. Not only that, depending on how you go about things in the wasteland, in the Commonwealth, such as if you kill innocent people, then some companions will like love this, whereas others won't. And depending on this, their relationship with you will increase. And when they do increase to a number or something, then they'll actually talk to you without you actually engaging with them to actually get them to talk. So they'll say like something like, can I have a moment or something with you? And you can say no or yeah, and then they'll start talking, and basically they'll start saying really nice things about you and all that stuff, and start talking about themselves and everything else like that.
Hey.
Ready.
Would it be possible to speak off the record for a moment?
Absolutely. Go ahead.
Thank you. This is difficult for me to say, so I hope you'll bear with me as I try to get through it.
When you were first placed under my sponsorship, I had some serious reservations about it. Despite all that, this has turned out to be a rewarding experience for both of us. At this point, honestly, I don't feel like there's anything else I could teach you about being a Brotherhood soldier that you don't already know. It's apparent from your attitude and your actions that you intend to keep those ideals close to your heart.
And not only that, you can actually romance with them. That's right, romance is in this game, but it's not as much as Mass Effect's romance. There's no goddamn, you know, sex scenes, there's nothing like that in this game. It's just basically when you have a romance partner, if you go into a bed, and with them next to you and sleep for an hour or more, then when you wake up, you have an XP boost for a limited time, which is pretty awesome. So the AI in this game is alright, it is okay, but the creature AI, that's where it gets awesome. You have the crazy creature-like animals called Deathclaws, which are just so cool, and they're so tough to kill. And not only that, when you shoot them, they strafe. They try and dodge all your shots, and then they run at you, and they grab you, and they try and fucking eat you. And it's so cool when you see these animals strafing across the Commonwealth, just trying to dodge your shots, and then you're wasting all this ammo because you're missing at them. And it's so, so cool, and it's so awesome. Whereas the companion AI is okay, it's nothing special. Sometimes they won't really do that much. Most of the time they may stand in your way. I've had that happen to me a couple of times, but not enough times to make me get really angry with them. At least the companions don't actually die on you, they just kind of go to the ground and you can revive them, but if you don't want to revive them, they'll revive themselves eventually. Oh my god, let's talk about the loot. So the loot in this game is insane. This Fallout 4 basically redefines loot as something actually useful. In other games, you may have forks and stuff which are there, and you can steal them and stuff like that, but you just use them is to sell them for maybe 2 gold or something. In Fallout 4, you get knives and forks as well, you get microscopes, you get every single thing, and every single one of them is made out of a component which you're going to be needing to either enhance your armor, enhance your weapons. You're going to be needing those components, such as forks are made of steel, so you get a steel thing from it. From other things, you get all these other components, such as adhesives, nuclear waste material, all that stuff which you're going to be needing to increase your armor and to just increase your arsenal. So instead of just going around in Fallout 4 just picking up ammo and health packs, ammo and stim packs and radaways to, you know, keep you alive, you'll be going around picking up every damn thing you see, from cameras to microscopes to forks to knives to plates to hot plates to coffee machines. You'll be picking up every damn thing because you're going to be needing them in the future. So in Fallout 4, they've added in legendary bosses, which basically are normal bosses, but they have more XP and they do more damage. But when you kill them, you get a legendary weapon. And the legendary weapon is kind of just disappointing. It doesn't look any different from any other weapon. You can basically create the same weapon at the workbench. The only difference is it has a special ability which, if you create a weapon, won't have, such as there's 50% more damage to robots, 50% more damage to ghouls, does 20 more damage to limbs, but has higher recoil. It has all those different stats, and it's really awesome. The thing is, though, since they don't look any different, it doesn't really compel you to actually use them. Not only that, if you get a really awesome perk, a really awesome stat on one of these weapons, but you don't really want to use that weapon, you can't take that stat and put it onto a weapon which you really love. So weapon crafting in this game is awesome, it's so cool. You're going to be having a massive blast of a time just creating weapons. By using all of the material which you found up out in the wastelands, such as knives and forks and oil and steel and all that stuff, you can upgrade your weapons by having take a pistol, give it a new barrel, give it an automatic receiver, so basically you get a machine gun pistol, you do all that things. And then you can also rename your weapons to give it some kind of personality. Same with your armor, you can rename your armor, you can upgrade it so you take less radiation damage, higher stealth. You can do all that stuff, and it's so good and so immersive, and you're going to be playing this game for hours just getting your right equipment right. So in Fallout 3, you had the power armor and the New Vegas, and basically the power armor is just armor, you could wear it anytime you want, and it was just better protection for you. In Fallout 4, they changed the power armor to make it a little bit less accessible, but make it even more powerful and even more awesome than ever before. Basically, the power armor in this game is like an exosuit which is run by nuclear cores, which you have to find out in the wasteland. Which you have to find out in the Commonwealth. So you power these suits with these fusion cores, you put them inside, and you can, it's basically just a massive suit of armor, and it's just like a massive tank, basically. And you can tromp around, you can do everything, and you can even upgrade the armor as well to make it even better. You can give it a jetpack if you want, so it flies up and you can crash back down to do tons of damage. You can do all those kind of things, and it's awesome. You even have a perk which actually increases the power armor damage depending on what you're doing. Such as if you run into an enemy that may actually stumble, and then the next perk after that would be if you run into an enemy that will actually stumble and take massive damage. And then after the fusion core runs out of power, then the entire system shuts down and you got to come back out again. So yes, there is bugs in this game. There's of course going to be bugs in this game, but there's nothing that's actually going to take you away from the experience of playing the game. There's one bug where your gun won't show up when you put it out, but that's not really that much of a problem. It goes away quite fast. Some other bugs are a bit bigger, such as the game actually full-on crashing on some points. There's obviously going to be frame loss. I had frame loss when I was on top of a big building and I could look around across the entire Commonwealth and the game was trying to render out every damn building it can see. Which pulls us onto another point. The graphics in this game are good. I don't know why people are complaining about the graphics, because the graphics are actually pretty impressive for this game. It's the best looking Fallout game ever, and the landscapes in this game is awesome. They're so good, and I don't know why people are complaining about the graphics. The only time you can see that the graphics are out of date is when you look at the character models, such as the Super Mutants.
He's dead, whether you believe me or not.
There's no question it's difficult to believe. Kellogg was ruthless. There's a reason the Institute used him to do their dirty work for so many years. I knew they'd send him after me. Tried to prepare for it. But I still wasn't sure I'd make it. And so
also, the weather effects in this game are so good. You can get rain, you can have fog, you can have clear blue skies, and then you can also have a storm which comes in from the glowing sea, which basically pulls in all this radiation, and it basically becomes a massive green-yellow fog around you with lightning going across the sky. And every time a lightning happens, basically you gain radiation poison, you gain radiation for maybe a second. New to Fallout is basically you're able to create your own, well, towns. You're able to create your own wee facilities for your followers to come along and to stay and basically live. Now, this is actually a really awesome system. In fact, I've probably put in more than 5 hours into just building up a place for random people to stay, just to create something. And actually, you're not forced to use it. This is how Fallout does things. It's all free. It's all freedom. You're not forced to do anything, but you can if you want to. And it's so good if you can. I've had so much fun doing it just by creating something, and I always want to do it from now on. The problem with it is the controls seem a bit clunky when doing things. It's not that good. It almost feels like Halo 3's Forge almost. But it's still got some stuff there which is awesome to do. The only problem is it doesn't actually tell you how to do things, so you're kind of left at the beginning of the game wondering what actually can you do, such as, I had no idea that you could actually set up supply routes between your settlements, and this was 50 hours into the game. 50 fucking hours when I've already put in probably 10 of those hours into creating a settlement. Yeah, why did no one tell me this? You can put up defenses, you can put up all turrets, you can do everything, you can basically make a settlement, which is so cool, and make it your own wee home. You can also send all of your companions to that settlement so that you know where all of your companions are. So if you want to have a different companion, you can go to that one settlement and take that one companion with you. Another thing which is good about companions, which I didn't actually mention, when you're doing quests and stuff like that, they may even actually integrate into the dialogue of the main guy that's giving you the quest. Such as, I remember I was in the Brotherhood of Steel getting something taught to me by the elder person, and my companion Piper actually just started talking just randomly, giving more explanation into it, and then the elder actually explained something to her as well. Which was so awesome, it added to the immersion, it made the companion seem like a person, and it's just brought this game home. So you're going to be spending way over 60 hours into this game for possibly one character. So if you want to create a second character, you're good on you. You got over 120 hours just playing through the game, exploring, doing all the things you can. I haven't even finished the fucking game. I finished the campaign, I finished the main storyline, I haven't explored everywhere though. I still have to find all the companions, and that's what I'm going to be doing. So this game is a must own. If you don't like RPGs, I suggest you start off with Fallout 4. Fallout 4 just takes RPGs to the next level, but it's not redefining the gaming industry, it's not bringing anything new to the table. Basically, what Bethesda did was create an incredible game which they already had ideas for from all their other games, but they re-brought these ideas into Fallout and then just revamped it all to create something immersive and something awesome. So Fallout 4 gets a solid 9 out of 10. It is a must own to everyone. If you don't like RPGs, this is the one to start off with. It's so much exploration. It redefines RPGs. It's so good of a game. The story's great. And you're going to be having, you're going to be spending tons of hours into this game. So if you're one of those people who think that putting an hour into a game is like getting £1 back for your, from your money, then 60 hours into this game for maybe for a £40 game, you know, you've already made a £20 profit off of that. And you can actually, and it's more than 60 hours, to be honest with you. The only thing that holds this game back from a 10 out of 10 is, of course, the bugs, the kind of low-end graphics for the character models. But none of that stuff actually takes away from the experience. And also, no kind of cooperative play, you can't play with your friends over Steam or whatever. But otherwise, this game is a solid 9 out of 10. You're going to be having so much fun in this game. You'll be spending so much time in this game also. So I really highly recommend you get Fallout 4. So everyone, thanks so much for watching this video, and I'll see you all in the next one. Bye-bye!
Send that man down!
I don't think we're alone.
Tango down!